analytical skills are paramount in today's workforce. To be competitive, our students will need to be able to collect data, evaluate the trends the data reveals, and think critically about how to respond to the trends.
Yes, I was reading an article the other day talking about this. Jobs that currently require routine work are being outsourced or automated, and therefore, today's students need to practice more analytical skills in classes in order to be prepared for their future jobs. We know worksheets and rote memorization assessments don't allow our students to practice their analytical skills.
Exactly. That's why I frequently create passion-based projects for students with the hope that their work will naturally include instances where they're practicing their analytical skills. Sometimes, however, I wonder whether I'm doing enough to reinforce the analytical skills that students need to be college and career ready.
Right. Just recently, my students created a project that used lots of the features in Excel Online. The students are using an Excel spreadsheet to collect information about the donations they are collecting, as well as the amount of trash they find near the wharf at Dog River every time we go. There are some great features in the Excel Online that the students didn't know about that can be helping us analyze and share our data.
Really? Like what?
Well, for the last 2 months, when I take my class to the wharf to pick up trash, I have them count out the pieces of trash that they pick up and record it in their Excel spreadsheet. In addition to charting the number of pieces we pick up, they are noting whether it has rained in the last 2 days. The students have noticed there's more trash after a rain shower. After 2 months of data, I guided them to create a chart that would show a visual of the pattern we were seeing. At first, I had them try just a basic column graph. It was a pretty good visual. It definitely showed that there was more trash when it has rained in the last 2 days. But the students noticed that it just didn't seem clear enough. So together, we tried some of the other charts. Look what happened when we tried the box and whisker chart. We think this is a much better visual for everyone to see how the rainfall impacts the amount of trash.
Which helps you prove that the trash here at school does impact what shows up at the wharf. What a great project.
That's not all. The students were working on keeping track of the donors who had contributed to the fundraiser. At first, they were thinking they were going to have to retype everyone's entry because when they first created the chart, the student doing the typing entered first and last names in different cells and didn't organize them by amount. So to make a list with the person's name and donation amount, someone was going to have to retype it all manually. But I showed them how to not only sort the donors quickly from smallest to largest donations, but also how to make a single line that quickly converts all our separate cells into one line of text.
I can see using this for sorting my class information as well. This will be a huge time saver.
I know. We can sort quickly and easily with the format table feature. I showed students how to highlight the cells they wanted to sort and filter, chose format table, and then create drop-down menus that let us filter by donation. Then, once the students had the donations filtered by amount, I showed them how to use the flash fill feature in the data ribbon to make a column that includes both the name and donation amount. Just type the first line how we want it. Here we put their last name, then their first name, and the amount they donated, and then click flash fill. Excel fills in the rest of the cells just like we did the first one.
Nice. Then once you have the one line with the donors' names and their donation, you can resort the cells based on the names so that everyone is alphabetized.
The analytical skills students are using with their project and the skills they are learning by using Excel will prepare them for the challenges that they will face in college and in their careers.